Deep into South America lies a relic that shines light on what may have been lost throughout time. It's an ancient place in between the Andean Mountains and the Amazon jungle. It's a lost chapter of an engineering achievement from an unknown line of ancient builders. This place has the bare bones of what was a lost civilization's use of their technology. It was to help sustain their civilization, or possibly something more advanced. This ancient site is called Yuraq Rumi, near a town called Vitcos. This place lies in an anomaly of an ancient skill that we perceive the ancient Incas not to have. These ancient civilizations were supposed to be at the bronze level or less with their technological skill set, but there are remnants of this ancient technology that still is present today. This archaeological site was recently uncovered, but it still looks to be in complete ruins. You'll see a lot of stones spread out across this place, but there are also large stones that have odd shapes. Some of these stone shapes do not make sense, but when in fact, they serve a specific purpose. During ancient times, they all fit together to create a larger tool for this ancient civilization. The larger and heavier stones are only what's left along with the stone bases to provide a platform for certain stones once long ago. There are historical records documented by the Spanish conquistador Pedro Cieza de León, where he talks about these engineering stone marvels. This is in his Spanish chronicles of his travels across these ancient lands from the year 1532 to 1550 ACE. He mentions that the Incas had these sophisticated aqueducts that helped flourish their civilization. Although, their origin story has a strange and shocking tale of different humans that found these lands and built these structures ages ago. All of the Inca elders had said that their ancestors found these ruins and rebuilt them from the stones of which their gods originally built with, which was used in their ancient city. This Spanish conquistador wasn't just a fighter, but a cartographer and a linguist who documented information and history for the Kingdom of Spain at the time. Here's a quote from the book. "The Incas also watched and recorded the courses of some of the stars and of comets. They had a complete system of numerals. Perfectly balanced pairs of scales have been found in Peruvian tombs, and their administrators must have been in the habit of making and recording very complicated revenue accounts. Their year was divided into 12 months, and the great periodical festivals celebrated the periods of the solstices and equinoxes. The proficiency of the Quechuas in mechanical science was of a high order, as it attested by their magnificent roads and aqueducts, and by conveyance of cyclopean blocks of stone for their buildings. Marked on these stones are fittings for metal T-shaped joint locks. These locks used to hold some of the large monolithic stone blocks together. What's significant about this is that this ancient civilization used metal smelting rather than using basic stone tools. With the utilization of metal smelting, they must have used plenty of other metal tools that are unknown to us today. One of the most intriguing pieces at this ancient site is a large black stone that has flat surface on the rock all over it. This black rock is located on the opposite side of the town of Vitcos, which rests below the ancient temple and stronghold called the Rosas Pata. It has the same look as the stone blocks that you'll find around in Sacsayhuaman in Cusco and around various other locations in the Sacred Valley of the Incas. I believe these are flat bases to lay larger stones on top of them to create the polygonal style buildings and walls that you normally see in Peru. This site is called Chinchero, which is miles apart from other locations that have the megalithic polygonal style. Here is another example that is miles away called Ayantaytambo. It's located in the Amazon jungle. These bases are for blocks to create this type of stonework. Were these the types of buildings these ancient stone masons used to live in, or were they used for something else? The large black stone poses as a different type of stone structure. It does have the similar flat bases for stones to rest upon, but due to the stone structure being outside and next to a source of water, it was used as a Stone Age machine. I believe this was a stone structure that was used to regulate water and act as an aqueduct. This used to be a building that acted as the distribution station for the ancient aqueduct. This large black stone base that used to house a building led into conduits to distribute more flows of water. Down below the large black rock, there are more stone blocks that are slightly different. There are 9 of these blocks, but the interesting thing about these are that they're made from the stone base below and not individual stone blocks. These were the conduits that channeled water into different directions. Each space has weathering marks from consistent water erosion. The lighter and drier portion was covered by other stones to act as a top cover and to regulate the current flow of the water. This was to create a softer water flow on the slanted stone base to flow into the water channel below. This could have acted as part of the distribution center to clean and regulate the water. From these conduits, there would have been stone blocks channeling this water and possibly stones that held water just like the Romans made, or different channels to these fountains. Some Inca stories say that these were just seats for ritual ceremonies, but that may not be true. Besides written texts by Pedro Cieza de Leon commenting on the aqueducts, another Spanish general named Garcilaso de la Vega also wrote about these aqueducts. Here's a quote directly from the Spanish conquistador. The authenticity of the aqueducts, describing it as a beautiful ditch whose current was diverted in a way contrary to the direction of the river. Because a river that passes through the valley brought very little summer water, and the Indians suffered a lot of sterility in their fields, which many years in the mountains it rained little. They lost because of lack of irrigation, and with the aid of the canal, which was greater than the river, they enlarged the lands of labor in more than the same, and from then on they lived in great abundance and prosperity. At the end of this aqueduct's distribution center lies one of the ancient builders' fountains. This was one of many fountains that distributed the water to the surrounding area. These fountains were also a very common thing to exist during this ancient time. This was essential to sustain the civilization by providing water to the surrounding area. These were allegedly built by the Incas, but some of the common Inca origin stories say that their ancient creators built these. Inside the fountain, there are knobs sticking out at the side, which resemble the knobs seen at other ancient megalithic sites. Could these knobs serve a purpose or be used as some placeholder to serve multiple purposes? These mysterious stone protuberances have been found across many ancient sites throughout the world. The reason why they're still a mystery is that they're used for many different purposes, not just one mysterious reason. Although for these knobs, they could be placeholders to hold a wooden beam. It was a beam to hold containers of water or for a small water wheel. Even though some may imagine that these stone knobs were for a more advanced purpose close to the level of sci-fi, they were actually used for a more practical method. Although the mystery isn't about the type of technological advancement that this civilization had, it's where they got this shared knowledge and the origin story which started their ancient civilization. As you view this from the sky, you'll see the villages on the left side while the right side is less populated. There are rivers that almost surround this piece of land on the left and right side, but the area where the river doesn't reach is where the aqueduct channels are. The significance of this engineering marvel is that these builders built this to enclose this giant piece of land to capture the water more efficiently. You can even find more traces of these types of rock buildings and formations in the stone further up where the aqueduct connects to the one river. There are multiple areas where stones have odd shapes along the areas where they hold water in swamp environments today. This entire streak of land was covered in step terraces, with fountains bringing water to the land for agriculture reasons. Since the ancient Incas always state that they did not build these stone structures, Who were these ancient builders that created these engineering stone marvels from the distant past? The clues can be found towards the top part of this piece of land, which is surrounded by water. At the top of this narrow point was the center of the structure. This was the last Inca temple and stronghold called Rosas Pata or Vitcos. This site was occupied by the Incas of Vilcabamba during the Inca resistance. It was attacked and looted by the Spanish conquistadors, which resulted of it being abandoned by the Incas and hidden until the early 20th century. Hiram Bingham III discovered the site on August 9, 1911. Bingham noted that the Augustinian monks, Friar Marcos and Friar Diego, led their native converts to burn the Temple of the Sun and burn the Yuraq Rumi structure when the current Inca emperor was absent. Why were the Incas protecting this last sacred site, and what was the significance of it? Did the entire site serve a much greater purpose? The identity of the ancient builders and purpose of these structures is from the description of historical texts and shown by the characteristics of the artistic style of these structures. They have strange hinge-like features and knobs that utilize the stone in multiple methods for connectors. They also use giant rose granite blocks for their entryways. You can tell that the larger stones were the original stones that were placed. This temple has a lot of ancient blocks, but what's very intriguing is that while you're overlooking the pathway that leads to this ancient place, you see something eerily familiar. It almost has the look of a pyramid. Could this be entirely man-made, or a mountainside shaped into a pyramidal structure? Could the ancient Incas be hiding a much older structure, which may have been a giant pyramid? What was the original look and function of this site during ancient times? An interesting quote from Pedro Cieza de León states, "When the Indians are asked who built these ancient monuments, they reply that a bearded man and white people like ourselves were the builders, who came to these parts many ages before the Incas began to reign, and formed a settlement here. These, and some other ancient edifices in this kingdom, do not appear to me to be like those which were erected by order of the Incas. For their buildings were square, and those of the Incas are long and narrow." The rediscovery of this lost engineering stone marvel not only sheds light on ancient craftsmanship, but also serves as a monument of intelligence. As we encounter these unearthed fragments of history in remote corners of the world, we learn a small piece of the chapters of our lost history. These master stone builders transformed the landscape, redirected water flow, and sculpted enormous stones to erect their enigmatic monoliths. Their origins remain a mystery, with only remnants of their ancient stone marvels left to be rediscovered.